Welcome to the Lifetime Assembly Channel. My name is John, and today I'm going to help you assemble your 8x10 outdoor storage shed. Before we get started, make sure the model number of your shed is listed in the description below. This video will follow the steps outlined in your assembly manual that comes with the shed. If you've already begun and need help on a specific step, check the comments or description below for a timestamp associated with each step. The shed comes on a pallet in two separate boxes. Let's take a look at what you should have received. There are steps within this assembly that require more than one person, so be sure to have at least one other adult available to help. Before we begin the assembly, let's take a look at the tools you'll need to complete the job. You'll need a 7/16 wrench, a 3/8 wrench, an adjustable wrench, a rubber mallet, a box cutter, a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips head screwdriver, needle nose pliers, a hammer, safety glasses, a ladder, a drill. You may see us use an impact driver. If you decide to use one as well, be sure not to over torque or over tighten the hardware. 5/16 wood drill bit, and a 5/16 masonry drill bit. To make this easier, we're going to use a 7/16 socket, a 3/8 socket, a socket adapter, a Phillips bit, a pair of vice grips, and a block of wood. All Lifetime sheds require a foundation to be built on. We recommend building one from concrete, but you can also build one out of lumber. This video is meant to be a companion to the manual and not a direct replacement, so for the best results, make sure to have your manual available during the build. Also, it's crucial that you refer to the assembly manual to review the safety instructions for this build to prevent serious injury or property damage. All right, let's get started.
Hacer clic en la esquina inferior derecha de este video para ver los subtítulos en español.
Section 1 will go over how to build the foundation for your shed. This video will focus on the assembly of your shed and not the foundation. So refer to your instruction manual to see how to properly build your foundation or call customer service. Take two gutter channels and align the holes in the ends with the holes in the connector. Secure the gutter channels to the connector with the hardware. Align the holes in the ends of the truss brace with the holes in the gutter channel. Secure the truss brace to the gutter channel, making sure that the head of the bolt is on the inside of the gutter channel. To make tightening this easier, I like to use a Phillips bit inside some vice grips. Slide a truss rod through the large truss brace, adding a small truss brace and into the connector. You'll know the truss rod is tight when it doesn't wiggle. Be careful not to over-tighten because you don't want to break the cap nuts. Repeat the previous steps two more times for a total of three assemblies. Take the gable halves labeled AGH and AGI and align them in the middle. Secure the halves together in the middle with the hardware. Align the holes in the screen with the holes in the vent. Place the vent on the front of the gable and align the holes. Secure the vent to the gable with the hardware on the backside. Take the square tube that doesn't have any small holes next to the square hole in the middle and insert a cap into each end. Align the holes in the square tube with the divots on the gable, making sure that the dimples are facing down. Secure the square tube to the gable with the hardware. Take the two gable halves with a curve at the bottom and align them in the middle. Secure the two gable halves together with the hardware. Add the screen and vent to the front of the gable using the same method as before. Take the other square tube and insert a cap into each end. Lay the square tube on the back of the gable, making sure that the holes line up with the divots on the gable. Also make sure that the dimples are facing down and the square dimple is facing you. Starting with the center hardware, secure the tube to the gable. Finish securing the tube to the gable through the remaining six holes. Take the left door, which is the one with the logo, and a square tube, and make sure that the holes in the square tube line up with the holes in the door. Insert the square tube into the hole at the bottom of the door, and make sure that the end with the hole goes at the top and is on the same side as the front of the door. Make sure to leave a few inches of the tube hanging out the bottom. Insert the end cap into the bottom of the tube and then sew the tube the rest of the way up the door. Attach a left latch bracket to the door, making sure it's oriented like this. Only finger tighten the hardware for now. Now take the 1/8 provided drill bit and drill through the divots at the top and bottom of the door. You will be going through the metal in the underlying pole, so make sure your drill is fully charged and on the highest torque setting. At the bottom of the door, on top of the holes you just drilled out, add your spacer so you can read the word down, and your lock labeled number 2. Repeat the previous step at the top of the door, except this time the spacer needs to read up and you're using lock number 1. Connect the two halves of the handles together. Connect the handle to the door with the hardware. Slide the hinge shoe through the hole at the top of the door until a couple inches sticks out the bottom. On the back side of the door, add the butyl tape to the groove around the edge of the window. Pull the film off both sides of the window. Align the holes in the window with the divots on the door over the butyl tape. Secure the window to the door with the hardware. Insert the square tube into the bottom of the right door using the same method as the left door. Insert the cap into the bottom of the tube and then push the tube all the way up. Secure the tube to the door through the divot at the bottom of the door with the self-tapping screw. Attach the latch hardware to the door, making sure it's oriented like this. Attach the two halves of the handles together. Attach the handle to the door, making sure to add the bracket to the back oriented like this. Insert a hinge tube into the top of the door until a couple inches sticks out the bottom. On the back of the door, add the butyl tape around the outside of the window. Remove the plastic film from both sides of the window. Align the holes in the window with the divots on the door over the Beetle tape. Secure the window to the door with the hardware. Now we're going to put the floor panel together with the help of another person, have them stand on the floor panel while the other person lifts the floor panel up, interlocks the tabs, and then lays it back on the floor. The doors can go on either short edge. So decide which edge you want them to go on and place the bushings into the circular holes. Secure the floor panels together by screwing through the divots on each edge of the floor panel. On all the wall panels labeled AHD, add a wall support to the channel just to the left of the cutout at the top, and make sure that on the end with the two holes on your wall support is also at the top. On the corner wall panel labeled AGY, add the wall support to the furthest channel on the right and make sure that the end with the two holes on the wall support is at the top. On the corner wall panel labeled AGN, add a wall support to the furthest left channel, making sure that the end with the two holes close together on the wall support goes at the bottom. On the window wall panel, add the short wall support to the center channel. Secure the wall support to the wall panel. You will need to insert the hardware at an angle. To the left of this bushing, insert the tabs at the bottom of the corner wall panel labeled AGY into the slots right here. Slide the wall panel over to lock it into place. I'm comfortable kicking the wall panel over with my foot. If you're not, use a block of wood and a rubber mallet. Fold the wall panel in half, lean it away from the corner, and align the tabs at the bottom with the notches in the floor. Apply downward pressure until you hear the tabs lock into place. Next to the corner wall panel, grab a wall panel labeled AHD, align the tabs with the cutouts in the floor, and slide it over to lock it into place. Before securing the two wall panels together, make sure the line at the top of the two wall panels is even. For your window wall panel, you can add it anywhere a regular AHD wall panel would go, except for the back wall. We're going to put ours right here. Add another AHD wall panel using the same method as before. For this corner, you're going to add the corner wall panel labeled AGW using the same method as the first corner panel. The next two panels must be AHD wall panels. For this corner, you'll need to use corner wall panel labeled AGL. Continue adding wall panels labeled AHD to this edge of the floor. For this corner, you'll need corner wall panel labeled AGN. Your shelf goes in the back wall. There are three different height settings. Decide where you want to put your shelf and insert the brackets into the cutouts on the wall support. Take your shelf and fold the flaps on the ends up. Place your shelf on the brackets, making sure that the edge with the notches is against the back wall. Secure the shelf to the wall and the brackets. With the help of another person, slide the hinge tube into the bushing, making sure that the hole in the hinge tube lines up with the slot in the bushing. Next, slide the cotter pin through the bushing and the hinge tube, and then expand the cotter pin to lock into place. Repeat the previous steps for the other door. With the help of another person, lift the gable with the curve in it onto the hinge tube at the top. Align the holes in the gable with the divots in the wall panel and secure with the hardware. Now add your gap flaps oriented like this. Take a truss assembly and insert it into the notches on the first wall panels. With the help of another person, lift a roof panel over the gable and into the gutter channel. You'll know the roof panel is in the correct position when the alignment nub is in the notch. Secure the roof panel to the wall panel through the bottom four holes. Continue securing the roof to the truss and the gable. Insert the roof support into the notch over the gable and the truss. Finish securing the roof panel through the remaining three holes. Repeat the previous steps for the roof panel on the opposite side. Add two more trusses and four more roof panels using the same method as before. with the help of another person, lift the rear gable onto the back wall and secure with the hardware. Install the final two roof panels using the same method as the other roof panels. Starting at the back of the shed, place a roof cap labeled AGG over the gable and secure with the hardware. Add the next three roof caps labeled AFY, overlapping the previous roof cap and securing through the roof panels and the truss. Add the final roof cap labeled AFW to the front of the shed. Insert a skylight through the hole in the roof, line up the holes, and secure with the hardware. Add the next three skylights using the same method as before. Take the window panel and remove the plastic film from both sides. Insert the window into the window frame, making sure that the lip on the window is facing out. Insert the screw into the hole at the bottom of the window. Add the latches to the divots above the window, leaving the hardware loose so the latches can slide back and forth. These cutouts in the walls are for your wall hooks. Place them wherever you would like throughout the shed. On every truss, add a truss gusset to each side oriented like this. The screws are designed to go through the metal, so be sure your drill is fully charged and on the highest torque setting. On every truss, lift up the small truss support until it's flush with the gutter channel and secure with the hardware. Next, you need to level your doors. To see a video on how to properly level your doors, follow this link here. Now we're going to tighten the locking hardware. Have someone go inside with the tools, close the door and lock it to make sure everything lines up. Then have the person on the inside tighten all the hardware. This section will go over how to properly anchor your shed to your foundation. Since we're inside, we're not going to be able to do that, but it's important that you do. So refer to section 15 in your instruction manual. Thank you for watching this video on how to assemble your lifetime 8x10 outdoor storage shed. If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up. For more content like this, subscribe to our channel. If you have any other questions, feel free to reach out to our customer service team and check out our other awesome products at lifetime.com.